Good morning, children. This is standard 5 English. Due to some network issue and inconvenience, I couldn't attend the online class today. So that is why I'm making this video and sending you the link of lesson 1, textual grammar. That is, whatever textbook work is there, I will be doing that. So tomorrow, if you have any issues or any doubts during the online class, you can clear your doubts. So, chapter 1, that is lesson 1, the man cub. It is completed with the explanation. In the previous classes, that is in the month of April, I gave you assignments, I gave you activity, which you stick to it. And now today, I want to complete the textual work, that is textbook work, whatever is there in the behind the lesson. Page number 4, about the text, below that, read and answer, write true or false for these statements, write true or false for these statements. The first one, the baby could not walk at all when Father Wolf saw him. The first statement is, the baby could not walk at all when Father Wolf saw him. So this statement is true. Second one, Sher Khan had come to the cave looking for the man cub. If you remember in the story, there's a tiger named Sher Khan who was desperately searching the human cub, that is Mowgli. So Sher Khan had come to the cave looking for the man cub. So this statement is also true. Third one, Father Wolf and Mother Wolf were afraid of Sher Khan. Father Wolf and Mother Wolf were afraid of Sher Khan. If you have read the story or if you have seen, you will come to know that Father Wolf and Mother Wolf were very bold and they were ready to fight for Mowgli with even with the pack of wolves and with Sher Khan, that is the tiger. So this statement is false. The statement says Father Wolf and Mother Wolf were afraid of Sher Khan. They were not at all afraid. So this statement is false. Sher Khan, next one, Sher Khan wanted the pack to know about the baby. Now Sher Khan is this tiger. He wanted the pack of wolves to know that Mother Wolf and Father Wolf had brought a human baby and taking care of him. So he wanted the pack of wolves to know. So this statement is true. Mother Wolf named the baby Mowgli. So Mother Wolf, she named the baby as Mowgli. So this statement is true. So the five fill in the blanks, sorry, the five true or false is given in the text. You have to read the lesson, understand and write the answers, that is true or false, in the space given. Now B part, under that B part, read these sentences and answer the questions with reference to context, that is RC. In short, we call it as RC, that is reference to context. It may be in the form of who said to whom and when it was said and why it was said. Okay, so to know this, you have to read the lesson, you have to understand the lesson. You have to read the lesson line by line so that you know which sentence comes in which paragraph or which part of the story. Now the first one, I have heard of it. I have heard of it, but never in Agpan. So this is a statement from the lesson. This is from the story. I have heard of it, but never in Agpan. So below this statement, there are three questions given, that is A, B, and C. Yes. Now to find whether the statement is present in the lesson or not, we have to go back and check. So where we will find this? You go to page number you have to read the lesson and then understand. Page number 2, the first statement, the baby could not, sorry, I have heard of it but never in a pack. So this statement is there on page number 2. You can see in the conversation part there, it is between father wolf and mother wolf to your left hand side. I have heard of it but never in a pack. I could hurt him with my foot, but see, he looks up and isn't afraid. So this statement, what is given in that RC, it is present. And below that, there are three questions that follows. That is, who said these words and to whom? Who said these words and to whom? It is Father Wolf said these words to Mother Wolf. The first part, that is A1, who said these words and to whom? Father Wolf said these words to Mother Wolf. Father Wolf said to Mother Wolf. Second one, who was being talked about? The statement is asking, the question asked is about whom they were talking. So they were talking about Mowgli, the human baby whom they found in the forest, who was crawling on the ground and seeking help. So who was being talked about? They were talking about the man cub, that is Mowgli. The third one, what had been heard of? Mother cub wanted to keep the man cub along with her children and rear him up. I mean to say, Mother Wolf was very much interested of taking care of the human baby, that is man cub, along with her own cubs. She wanted to take care, give him protection and bring him up like her own child. So option A, B and C, it is not options. The statement is there, below that followed by three questions. So the first one, who said these words to whom? Father Wolf said to Mother Wolf. Second one, who was being talked about? So they were, Father Wolf and Mother Wolf were discussing about, they were talking about the man cub. And the third one, what had been heard of? That father was shocked to hear about mother's words, that she wanted to keep the human cub with her and take care of the human cub just like her own child or her own cub. The second one, am I to stand noisy into your dog's den for my fair dues? The second one, am I to stand noisy into your dog's den for my fair dues? So to find where this statement is in the book, we have to turn back, go to page number 5, right on top, am I to stand noising into your dog's den for my fair dues? It is I, Sher Khan, who speaks. So the statement is also present in the lesson in the form of conversation, and below that follows the questions. And what are these questions? We will see. Who said these words and to whom? Who said these words and to whom? So it is none other than Sher Khan. Excuse me. It is Sher Khan who said to Father Wolf when Father Wolf was guarding the mouth of the cave, the entrance of the cave. You can see on page number 5, you can see Father Wolf waiting at the entrance of the cave, and outside you can see Mr. Sher Khan, who's telling this, "Am I to stand noising into your dog's den for my fair deeds?" So who said this? It was said by none other than Sher Khan. He said it to Father Wolf. He said it to Father Wolf. Second one. Second question, where were these words spoken? Where were these words spoken? Father Wolf was at the entrance of the cave. Father Wolf was at the entrance of the cave, and Sher Khan was just outside the cave, and he was waiting for Father Wolf to give him permission to take away the man cub, or he was asking him to return the child, that is the man cub. So it happens when Father Wolf was waiting at the entrance of the cave, and Sher Khan says that. What does the speaker mean by my fair dues? Now, what does the speaker mean by my fair dues? What does it mean? Your fair dues. The speaker means to say that, give my prey back. That is, what does he want? He wants the human baby. He wants the man cub. Why does he want the man cub? He only wants to have a feast on him. He only wants to attack him. He only wants to attack a man. He wants to eat him. So that is, he's waiting at the entrance of the cave, asking him to return the man cub. So today, due to some technical issue, I couldn't attend the class. So that is why I am making this small video for you, so that you don't waste your time. At least you can go through the first part, that is true or false, and the second part, that is reference to contest, which are given in the textbook. Now, answer these questions briefly. These questions, along with few simple questions, I will be sending you a few questions based on the lesson, which you have to read the textbook, read the lesson, understand and find the answers for yourself. You have to find it out yourself, and remaining the long answers, that is the big answers, I will be sending it to you in the school app. And now the third part, that is prefixes. Read these sentences. Sher Khan was unhappy about the wolves keeping the man cub. Here the word unhappy has the group of letters un at the beginning added before the word happy. Similarly, the words incapable, imperfect, disrespect, proactive, and antibiotics have the groups of letters in, dis, pro, and anti, respectively, added to some other words. Such group of letters that are added in front of some words to form new words are called prefixes. Okay, children, I remember last year we have learnt about prefixes and suffixes in the textbook. This time when we are learning the grammar part, suffixes and prefixes will be introduced to you. Like prefixes, you have to add certain words or letters before the word, and suffixes is you have to add after the word. So that in detail you will learn when we are doing the grammar part with you. But now, since in the first chapter we have to complete the textual work, what is given, we have to do it accordingly. So there are words given there. There are 12 words given for which we have to add suitable prefixes. Pre in the sense before. So we have to add suitable prefixes to make a new word, right? And suffixes, we add some words or some letters after the word to make a new word. So prefixes and suffixes are two different things. Pre is before and suffix is after the word we have to add. There are, you will get some words, you will find some changes. Now for example, in the textbook what is given, we will do it today. Suffixes we will do it tomorrow when we have the online class. And some other grammar part what is there in the textbook. That is page number 5, add in, im, an, dis, pro or anti to these words to make new words. So page number 5, section A, we have to add in, im, an, dis, pro or anti to these words to make new words. So children, I stop here. We'll continue it tomorrow with prefixes, suffixes. We will study again what are prefixes. We will study again what are suffixes. Yes, and the remaining part of the grammar, the textual grammar, that is syllabus, dividing the words into their syllables. Dividing the words into syllabus. Last year I had done, I don't know how many still remember it, but tomorrow once again I will do it. Yes, so that in the rest of the grammar part will be covered in the next session. So till then you can just have a practice of these two, what I did, that is the two of us and the RC. If possible, you try and solve page number 5, the prefixes and suffixes on page number 6. Page 5 and page 6, you can just have a look, and if possible, if you are able to do it, you do it. The remaining, we will continue in the next class, that is in tomorrow's session. So till then, take care. Bye.